Hey everybody, welcome back to Record-ology. Okay, this is a super, super exciting day for me. As you know, those of you that have been watching the show for some time, the one thing we didn't have in the collection, but we do now, is a picture disc, which are super, super cool visual way to enjoy records. As you know, I've been looking for one of these and had an opportunity to pick one up. If you watched a couple of the videos recently on some of the newer records I've got, what happened was I was able to sell back some old books. Second and Charles got a buyback offer of about $90 and reinvested that in records, which is really exciting. So I saw this one. Disney has a bunch of their classic movie soundtracks available on picture disc. Had to pick this one up. So here we go. We actually have it, a picture disc. So this may surprise you, but picture discs have actually been around for a long, long time. Check out that artwork. It's just so cool. The 20s and 30s, you get shellac records that were picture discs with a clear recording surface, picture in the middle. So if you like do an image search or go on eBay and look at some of those, for not too much money, you can get some vintage picture discs, which are really cool. These new ones, though, the colors are so vibrant. They're so beautiful. And just love them. They don't even sell them in cardboard packaging. It's this this plastic surface, this plastic soft case thing that they sell it in because they want to show off the artwork of the disc. Now, some of you have heard that these are not as desirable. And the reason why, that is true, by the way, they're desirable for the sense of their aesthetic qualities, but they're not as desirable from an audio standpoint because they don't technically sound as good as a regular vinyl record. Why is that? Because the way this works is there's actually a paper picture with a clear vinyl pressing on each side. Sandwiched in there is that picture. So the groove depth is not, it's narrower. It's not as deep as a regular black or colored vinyl non-picture disc record. So because the groove is shallower, there's less information for the stylus to get from the vibrations, and therefore its sonic qualities are more muted. So what that means is there's less dynamic range. Are you gonna notice this? Am I gonna notice this? 95% no. We're even gonna be listening to some of this on a really nice Iowa sound system today, off camera, but the speakers and the amplifier off camera. You're not gonna notice any difference. It's gonna sound amazing. It's gonna sound like any other record, unless you are one of the people out there, you know, looking to get the best quality audio possible by getting vinyl records. As you know, I don't do that. We do this for the aesthetic, for the fun, for the collecting, for the history. This whole channel specializes in affordable record players, affordable records, how to be a part of this hobby without investing a ton of money, and how to do it for free, if next to nothing. Even this record and the other ones that I recently got were, you know, didn't cost me anything out of pocket because I traded in a bunch of old dusty books and turned that around, made the investment back into records. So let's go ahead and open it. This, you know, if I want to listen to high quality audio and get the best sound quality possible, I'm going to be listening to a digital file. I'm not going to be listening to a record anyway. We've talked about why that is. You physically cannot get the CD quality audio on a record with this present technology. It just can't happen. The dynamic range and noise floor just isn't there in this medium. It's good. It's got a warm, soft tone that people love, but it doesn't have the true dynamic range that a digital file would. Okay, enough talking. Let's go ahead and open this up. So they come in these cases to show off the packaging of the actual record itself. It's got this little plastic belt to hold that flap down. Pulling this record out, first thing I notice is this is a thick, heavy-duty record. I mean, this thing is bulky. I wouldn't quite say it's 180-gram pressing like the Imagine Dragons one we reviewed recently, but it is probably 150 grams. I mean, it is thick. And I don't know if they, for picture discs, if they rate them that way, considering the extra weight of the paper, but the actual pressing feels really rigid, really stiff, very high quality. I love the black edge to this. Instead of it being clear, it's black. Something interesting, if you look at the punch out here in the middle, see if the camera can focus on, there we go. So you'll notice the picture in the center part here is the picture appears to be on the outside while the vinyl is on the middle, and then, you know, another coating of the picture on the other side. I think that's just for the center hole area, because obviously the vinyl surface needs to be on the outside for the majority of the playing surface, which goes to about right here, like a regular record. This whole area is not a playable surface. But anyway, Super, super, super cool. And again, from Disney, you're not going to get anything less than the best. I mean, this is just a gorgeous, gorgeous record. I love how the track listings are right there. The copyright information, everything's physically on the disc. So let's give it a little bit of a listen. We'll do a nice copyright friendly cursory listen. Welcome back, the Encore Entertainment Center. You guys noticed that this hasn't been on the show for several months. It's still around, still a great player. It's fully manual though, and that's why I don't use it as much. I have a hard time sometimes with my shaky hand dropping the needle gently. So let's give this a little bit of a listen here on the big system off camera. Now, isn't it awesome to see this thing just spinning on the turntable? It's beautiful. It's awesome, awesome, awesome experience. What a tactile, physical experience this is versus a digital file while you're staring off into space and listening to music, to be able to watch something visually happening. I'm going to play the other side just because you need to see both sides spinning. I mean, it's half the fun. So let's go ahead and listen to a little bit of this side as well. Very short lead-in on this record, I noticed. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed that little bit of a listen there. Had to be short for copyright reasons, obviously, but go ahead and go buy this for yourself. It is super cool. It's about $20, I think. It's not super expensive, but as you know, you try to do things on the cheap when it comes to records, record collecting, to show you how you don't have to invest a lot. But it's a good thing to ask for your birthday present or for a Christmas present, I think. They're available all over the place, online included. Anyway, hope you guys liked this video. Hope you enjoyed this. Hope you guys can find a picture disc for your collection as well. Go ahead and tell me about it in the comments below. And don't forget to hit subscribe. I'd really appreciate that. All right, guys, have a great rest of the day. And as always, happy record hunting.